Oh, it just got really bright all of
Yeah,
a sudden.
it did. Oh, now it's dark again.
Happy Wednesday. I had to think about what it
It is a weird
was.
week
It's a
because we're
weird,
closed tomorrow.
yeah. So today is like our Thursday, which is like
Yeah.
Friday, which is it's confusing.
Yeah, it is. It's exciting though. Tomorrow's Christmas Eve.
Tomorrow is Christmas Eve. Yay!
Very exciting.
Yay! I'm excited.
Me too. I didn't
You didn't
realize you
even
still had
notice
them on.
things, did you?
I noticed them earlier. I didn't realize.
I can't
You
hear
sound
your
like a
jingles.
cat.
I just look a cat. If you lose me in the clinic, just listen for the jingle bells. I just wear these all the time.
Yeah, I'll just get you a little collar. It'll be fine.
That would be
Why
awesome.
does it look like it's crooked?
That
But I
probably is
don't
crooked.
feel like we look crooked.
I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know.
Because we're just crooked normally and it's compensating.
Well, that makes us sound like we're thieves. We're crooked.
We're just, I don't know. I play my song? Crystal actually likes
Yeah,
this
I
song.
do. I
I'm
approve of
surprised.
it.
She actually knows this song,
I
which is
do.
amazing.
I might actually
And it
know
has
it.
nothing to do with anything that we're talking about.
Well, it kind of does.
I skipped it ahead. Hold on. Hold on.
Oh,
Hold,
no.
please.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Oh, well, hippopotamus will do. No crocodiles, no rhinoceroses. I only like hippopotamuses, and hippopotamuses like me too.
With what we're talking about, though, socializing puppies, and that's what we're talking about today, right?
Yeah, what is happening with the sun?
I put a blanket up because it
Whatever.
was really bright in here. I could hardly open my eyes, and the sun just is managing to find its ways in. But then it like goes away for a
Comes and
minute, and
goes.
then it comes back. So,
Whatever. Half the time we just won't be able to see anything. That's
yeah,
fine.
that's all right.
That's okay.
But I mean, I feel like it kind of goes with what we're talking about. A lot of people get pets for Christmas. I just spit. It goes with
True.
it.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I always tell my husband if he doesn't know what to get me,
Another puppy. Or just an old dog.
I would like an old dog. I want an old dog.
Yeah.
Not right now. We have plenty. We have four dogs. We're good for a little bit. But
Yeah.
I would like an old dog. I like those old folks. I like the little gray faces and but I get it. A lot of people like puppies because they are fun. They're cute.
They're a lot of work,
They're a
though.
lot of
I
work.
will never have
That's
another
why they have
puppy.
to be so cute.
Yeah, I will never have another puppy.
Same thing with kittens. They're trouble. So it's a good thing they're cute, or no one would have them. So we're talking today about socializing puppies and kittens. I don't think anybody, I don't think a lot of people think as much about socializing the felines as they do about the dogs, but it's important for both. So especially right now, we are seeing lots and lots of COVID puppies, Christmas puppies. You know, people are like, well, I'm home anyway.
Right.
It's a perfect time to get a puppy and house train them and that, which is, it's kind of a mixed bag, honestly. I mean, yeah, there's definitely pros to it. But there's definitely some things to take into consideration. And think about, make sure you're meeting all of their needs. So one of the big ones is socialization. So in puppies and kittens, there's kind of like this perfect time period when they're young that they've kind of not really figured out to be afraid of a lot of things yet. They're a lot more brave than they are once they're past a certain point. And I believe that cutoff is somewhere around like 12 to 16 weeks, depending on the reference that you look at. So earlier socialization is better. So that's kind of what we're talking about today, and some ideas of some things that you can do. So what's our goal with socialization, Crystal?
We want to get them out, see as many things as possible, but in a good way. We want them to have
Yeah.
positive
And
reinforcement
that's
with
yeah,
things.
that's an important thing to mention is, you know, not just take them around a whole bunch of things. They need to be positive experiences. Yeah, for sure. So, I mean, if you just take him around a bunch of things, and it's not a good experience
maybe
for that
baby.
Maybe
you have a neighbor dog that is aggressive. You don't want to take your puppy around an aggressive dog for the first encounter it comes with.
Right. Because then what's going to happen? They're going to have a negative experience. Now we've done the exact opposite of what we're going for. Right. So, yeah, same thing with people and that. So, getting them used to different animals, different people, sounds, smells, different substrates. So different like textures like grass and concrete and gravel, and, you know, all those sorts of things.
Different ages of
teaching
people.
Teaching them stairs. Yeah, different ages of people, different genders of people.
You're one dog. Henry.
Oh, my dogs are.
He's a mess. Well, and the thing is, like, he was around kids when he was a baby. I feel like he must have had
something must
sort
have happened.
Of bad experience with a kid.
Yeah, I don't know. But it's both sad and funny because he's terrified of children in general, including babies. Mm-hmm. So Crystal's youngest, I mean, he's a year now. He's a little over a year. But even when he was a baby,
in a pumpkin seat, he wouldn't even get out of his seat.
Like, he can't do anything.
No.
He's a baby.
He's like, oh, look, it's Aunt Crystal. Oh, wait, she has that baby.
Yeah, he loves Aunt Crystal, doesn't want to see the baby. It's just, it's weird.
It's kind of funny.
He's just a weird dog, but I love him. So I don't know why he was around. I mean, I guess he wasn't really around babies, but he was around kids.
Yeah.
And
he was
afraid
of my oldest.
Yeah, he was even times. Yeah, and he's even been around, Brantley before.
Yeah.
And same thing too, my other friend's kid Logan. He had been around before and everything was cool and no problem. And then I don't know if he had a bad experience, if something happened. I don't know, we got some sketchy kids walking by our house. Who knows?
Yeah.
Yeah, he decided he didn't like children anymore. So that's super fun. So lucky for us, we don't have kids.
Yeah.
My pets are my children, so that's fine. So it needs to be a really positive experience for them the whole time.
I have an important question for you.
Yeah.
Are you wearing socks?
I am wearing socks. They're the no-show socks.
Oh, okay. I just looked down and...
Show the camera?
No, I just saw bare.
Yeah, I'm not weird like that. I wouldn't wear tennis shoes.
Well, I didn't think socks, but I was confused.
That's
sorry,
gross.
That was very important.
Gross. Unless they're like river shoes, like if I'm on a float trip.
Well,
I have like junky tennis shoes that I'll wear from that, but I don't put socks on. But
yeah, that's fair. It's very important.
That was a very important question.
I didn't want to forget.
So much education happening today.
There's like a strip of light right across my eyeballs.
I know. It's fine. So there's an article on the AKC website about socializing your puppy during times of social distancing, which is very helpful. So what are some things that they can do, Crystal?
During social distancing or in general?
Social distancing.
They can go for walks.
Okay.
Around the neighborhood.
Yep. So that's great for different substrates and stuff, getting them used to the leash and the collar, which is important as well. Because a lot of puppies, first time you put that on them, they don't like it.
The first several times.
They try to back out of it, and they're scratching at the collar, and they don't like it. So they need practice with that, definitely.
Car rides.
Yep. That's a good thing.
Puppy play camp. I don't know if they do that during... COVID,
they do, so they still do that, absolutely. So that's still available, and actually, so Weston Kennels, who's just across the highway from us, does a free puppy daycare on Wednesdays.
Really?
Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, I just heard about that recently.
Every Wednesday?
I don't know, I just
or
heard about it recently.
New people, like a first time?
I don't know.
Okay.
Call them for more details.
Yeah.
But, that's a great thing. So, again, getting them used to other animals, which is awesome. Getting them used to being away from you, because especially right now when people are home all the time, I think we're going to end up seeing a lot of separation anxiety when people are going back to work, and that your puppy needs to learn to be away from you.
Or it's if you get two puppies at the same time, they need to learn to be away from each other
They need to learn to function on their own.
It's great
a codependent relationship.
Yeah. Great to get them a friend, and you know, especially if it's one of their siblings or whatever, but they really need to learn that it's okay to be separated.
Yeah.
We have a few that come in together, not even necessarily relatives or same age, mm-hmm. but we have a lot of animals that come in together because yeah. one can't be left a home alone.
Yeah.
So I think starting that young is definitely a good, mm-hmm. good option.
Yeah. So, I mean, I think it's similar in children where, you know, they have to learn to cope on their own sometimes. Mm-hmm. That's good for them. To learn that independence, to gain that confidence. They need to be able to figure stuff out on their own. So, yeah. So, you know, give your puppy a break. Whether that's you go out for a walk or take a drive around the block, whatever. And teach them that they can be on their own and be fine. So that later, when they're 50 pounds... and 2 years old, they're not destroying your house every time you leave the house.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or losing their minds in the kennel.
And it's okay to kennel.
Yes. Yeah. Crate training is a beautiful thing. I feel like most people do it.
I've met a few people that think that it's mean in some way. And quite honestly, you know, I have 4 dogs. All of them are crate trained, or mm-hmm. they go in their crate when I'm gone, except for one.
Yeah.
And he goes into a bedroom. Mm-hmm. It gives me peace of mind because I don't have to worry about them sure. getting into a fight or getting into something in the house, destroying something.
Mm-hmm.
Because quite honestly, one of my dogs, she didn't have an issue eating things until she's like
10 years old.
And then she decided it was time to start eating some stuff she shouldn't be.
So that's fine. So a couple foreign body surgeries later.
Yeah, 2 foreign body surgeries later. So yeah, she now gets kenneled again. Mm-hmm. She wasn't for many years.
Yeah.
But she can't be trusted, so she goes in a kennel again.
Yeah.
I have a little chihuahua, and quite honestly, I'm afraid that he will fall off of something or jump off of something.
Oh, I thought you were going to say he was going to pee in the house.
Well, he does that too. Not often, but he does.
As chihuahuas like to do.
But no, I'm afraid he's going to fall off the couch or whatever and sure. break his leg, and I'm going to come home. Who knows how long he would be like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it gives me comfort knowing that he's safe in a kennel.
Yeah, and I think as long as you treat that like that's their room, like it's not, mm-hmm. you don't treat it like a punishment. You treat it as though that's their safe space, that's their room. Then I think it's a good thing for them. And sometimes they like having a place that they can take a break from things that are going yeah. on. Especially, I think, too, if people have young children at home. Sometimes animals need to be able to have a space that's their own. That if they're, you know, yeah. feeling overwhelmed or, you know, there's too much going on. If you have company coming over that they're maybe not feeling great about, they've got a safe space they can yeah. go to.
That's where mine like to go to eat their treats.
Oh, yeah.
They're like, oh, this is mine. I'm going to take it home and I'm going to eat it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we do at my house, I've got 50% of my dogs are kennelled right now. I got the youngins and then I got a couple older ones. So they get peanut butter inside of a Kong, and that's the only time that they get it is when they go in their kennel. So they're super happy to do it. They're yeah. like, yeah, peanut butter time. Awesome. And they're happy. And it gives them something to do. It's their special treat that they get. So, yeah, they look forward to it. They're like, get out of here. I want my peanut butter. Yeah. They see us getting those Kongs ready in the morning. They're like, okay, Mom, wrap it up. Yeah. You got to go. I need my peanut butter. So there's, you know, there's that. And it, yeah, McCurry is young.
Hi, Brutus and Bosley.
Oh, Brutus and Bosley.
The beefcake brothers.
They're so
I love
cute.
It.
They're so cute. Hi, and Merry Christmas to you, too. So mine, that's their special place. That's okay. And Ms. Yeah. McMurray is the worst. So, yeah.
And then in my eye.
I'm sorry, is it your finger? McMurray is young enough still that he would get into all, he gets into all the things when we're home. So,
yeah.
He definitely would do that when we're away. So, he's a terrible dog. But then Henry, who's the other one that's kenneled still, so he's 3. I think he would be fine outside of the kennel. He sometimes, has some pee-pee accidents in the house for some reason. There's something wrong with his brain. He is the worst. So he goes in the kennel, and he's perfectly happy to do it. He's a big kid now, so he doesn't destroy things in his kennel. So he gets a little bed and everything now.
Yeah, Harley still doesn't get a bed.
Yeah, Big Murray doesn't. He's the worst.
Yeah, he's like 8 and
but,
can't have a bed.
Henry, too. So Henry's a weirdo.
Doug and Pretzel.
Doug and Pretzel show.
Oh.
he gets his toy now. He gets his special little ducky toy when he goes in his kennel now.
Oh, Henry.
That was my solution too. Cause so, side note, Henry's like the dumbest dog ever.
He's really sweet.
He's really sweet. He's really cute, but he is dumb. But he really likes soft toys. He spent a weekend at Grandma and Grandpa's house. And they have all of the soft toys, which are not usually allowed in my house because they get destroyed so quickly. But he did great with them. He loved the soft toys. So I was like, oh, okay, you know, I'll get him something. But he can only have it when the other dogs go outside. So what he started doing is he will go to the door. We have potty bells. So he'll go to the door. He'll ring the potty bells. And then he'll back up because he wants the other dogs to go outside so he can have his toy. So as dumb as this dog is, he's figured that out. Well, then the problem was he would ring the bells for the others to go outside, and then he'd refuse to go out because he wanted to play with his toy instead. So then we were having pee accidents in the house. So we had to take the toy away. He had to have a toy timeout. And so, yeah, that was my solution because he still, I still like him to be able to have his toy. I feel bad. But I also don't want him having pee accidents in my house. That's not fun. Yeah. Special toy in the kennel. See? Now it's a happy thing. Now it's okay. Yeah. Now he likes the kennel even more. He's like, Mom, I need my duck. He's cute. He's a troublemaker.
Aren't they
what
all?
What else do we got? So, other things that you can do, you can also take your pets to places like Home Depot and Lowe's. Allow pet animals in. They don't have to be service animals. They can just be your pets. As long as they're on a leash. So that's cool too. So again, more new sounds and smells and people. I would just
they
carry.
They do have treats there as
they
well.
They do have treats. Yeah. And I would always too, when you're trying to get your puppy out and about to learn new things and have positive experiences, find a really high value treat that they like, that they can be given either by you or by, you know, a stranger, whatever. And even, you know, interacting with strangers right now is not necessarily encouraged, but have a long leash, but not a retractable leash.
Right. Say that again.
A long leash, but not a retractable leash. You know, you can get a 6-foot leash. That's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Let them go say hi to the stranger, get a snack. Fantastic.
And then they come
back. It's a good thing. And then they come back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Without the violence of the retractable leash.
Without their weapon.
Without their weapon.
I hate them.
We're just really offended by those. I'm sorry. So those sorts of places. Where else can they go? There's other places I think that I've seen. Do they allow, they like let them at Rural King too,
yes.
I think. I think that's another one that, yeah, mm-hmm. I think my dad has taken the Great Danes out there before. And of course, parks are great.
And be careful too. Always ask, you know, is your dog nice? You know, if they've got a dog there too, you want to make sure that you ask first because
right.
I took Jace to Rule King once, and he's not bad with other dogs. It just depends.
Yeah.
He's real weird, and this person let
their
dog...
Well, and he's weird about food.
Yes.
Yeah.
And this dog, these people just let their dog run right up to him, and I was like, no.
Yeah.
No. He may not be good with them.
Right.
But it's not fair for me to not be able to take my animal somewhere because someone else isn't paying attention. So always ask that as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And taking them places like the pet stores and dog parks and that's great. I do, for those places, I typically recommend people wait till they're fully vaccinated, so at 16 weeks of age or older, because it's not like they're checking vaccine status at the door. Whereas if you take them to something like a puppy class, like at Weston, they are making sure everyone's vaccinated and good to go and keeping it as safe as possible. So I have unfortunately had a client that we treated her puppy for parvo, and like that same day when she picked him up to go home, took him to PetSmart, which I didn't find out till later, that puppy was still contagious. So cool. Great job.
I didn't know about that.
This has been many years ago.
Oh.
This was it, our first job.
Oh.
So it's been a long time. But still, like, that's not awesome.
No.
So that's why we recommend for those sorts of things. And same thing for puppy classes.
A leash story. It's not really a story.
No, they're just a collection of really poor experiences.
Yeah.
With them and leashes breaking and clotheslining people and other animals.
Or, you know, you go to grab the leash because they're taking off somewhere and then you get rug burn on your hand.
That's cool. So that's exciting.
You just don't have great control.
Most people don't seem to know how to lock their retractable leashes. So that's cool. We have a whole episode on that.
Yeah, we do.
Just go back and watch that. So vaccines are important. And so that's why, like, going to, like, and I'm not knocking their training, it's fine. Like PetSmart or Petco for training. It's not something that I typically recommend just because you're having to go through the store. And again, they're not checking the other animals that are coming in. People, unfortunately, are not smart sometimes. So going to a place like Weston, I feel like is safer.
I agree.
Plus, you know, that's important too. You know, I have people that'll come in with their new baby, and I'll ask about if they're planning to take them to any kind of training classes. And a lot of people are like, oh no, I've had tons of dogs before. I don't need to take them anywhere. Well, a training isn't just for training. Great if you already know how to teach your animal how to sit and stay and, you know, heal and all that. Cool. But it's also good for socialization, to get them out and about. So,
yeah.
I think it's a good thing to do, even if you're comfortable with the training portion of things.
Right.
So, let me see if I got anything else on my cheat sheet. I always forget to say, I always, like, realize after the fact that I forgot to say something, so. I like a cheat sheet. No, I think that's most of it. If you guys think of any questions or anything in particular.
Go back to my soapbox, though.
Okay, go back to your soapbox. Do it.
Puppies aren't gifts.
Oh, yeah.
It's right before Christmas. And I will tell you, well, except for you, yeah. I will tell you, 10 Christmases ago, we had two puppy presents, and then my parents went and got a puppy, now my chihuahua that I have, he is 11, so, yeah. I will tell you, only one of those dogs is still in its home. So it makes me sad. And they are a lifetime commitment. Mm-hmm. Their life.
Yeah. Research the breed.
Yeah.
For the love of God, research the breed. Know what you're getting into. Both personality and health-wise. Mm-hmm. Just because it's cute doesn't mean that it's right for you. There's a lot of dogs that I think are adorable. Like, I think a beagle is super cute, but it would not be good for me.
No,
herding dogs are gorgeous.
I think huskies are beautiful.
Not for me.
Yeah, but they're not couch potatoes.
Yeah, I mean, big, dumb couch potatoes is what fits into my lifestyle. That are not high energy.
That's my soapbox.
Mm-hmm.
So think about it, and also, you know, think about, like I said, in the last episode we had.
My last episode. Ooh.
If you get a puppy for your kids, plan on.
Did I spill coffee on
me? I think you did.
I probably did.
On them probably not taking the best care of them.
Yeah.
So you may end up with that responsibility and
assume that you will.
Yeah. Just make sure that you're okay with that if they stop taking care of it after a week.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine.
Yeah.
My thing.
There are puppies available in rescue.
Mm-hmm. There are.
You don't always have to buy from a breeder to get a really nice puppy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Or maybe an old dog. An old dog was like a home for Christmas, but not as a present.
Except for me.
Oh. Okay. okay.
Well, we had a client in today that she brought. She's got a kitten, but she also just adopted a senior pet, which I thought was really beautiful.
Yeah.
That's always nice. She said she didn't want him to spend Christmas in the shelter, which I thought was fantastic.
Which, honestly, they don't know any difference another day.
Well, they don't, but he still doesn't deserve to live out the rest of his days in a kennel. You know, he needs to be in a home where he's going to have lots of love, and he's going to be spoiled rotten with where he's at now. He's gonna have the best life. So, yeah, whenever time he's got left, it's going to be amazing for him.
Yeah.
And that's why I like the seniors.
Mm-hmm.
I got a soft spot. You got anything else? Any more soapbox?
No.
You're good now?
I'm good. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have no idea what we're going to talk about next week. I didn't come up with anything in particular.
I don't know either. We'll discuss it. We'll get back to you.
All right. And then we'll see you guys next week. Have a wonderful Christmas. Stay safe. Keep the chocolate away from your pets.
Yes.
We've had two of those calls already.
Yeah.
Within a week.
One of them was today.
Yeah. Keep the chocolate away. No table scraps.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next week.
Oh, no.
What have you done?
I don't know. You're still on, though. I can't.
Well, click outside of that. Anywhere.
I can't.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, there we go. Oh, okay. There we go.
It's like we've never.